Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for January to March 2017. Summer is underway and we've already had bushfires, heat waves and storms, but no tropical cyclones yet. The outlook for the first quarter of 2017 suggests a dry and warm start to the year, particularly in eastern Australia, with raised fire potential. First, let's wrap up winter and spring. After a very dry start to the year, and despite continued dry conditions in southwest WA, it was Australia's wettest May to September on record, bringing flooding to parts of the east. Nowhere was this change more obvious than in Tasmania, which had its driest 7 months on record to April 2016, immediately followed by its wettest 7 months on record from May to November. However, the above average rainfall eased in October for most places. Water storages in the eastern states are still much healthier than at this time last year, thanks to the winter and spring rains. The rains also meant soil moisture was very high across eastern Australia through to October. But dry, warm and windy conditions in November and December have seen soils drying very quickly. Vegetation in many areas responded to the wet soils with strong growth in winter and spring. The dry end of the crop season was ideal for harvest, with the Department of Agriculture forecasting record high yields. The warm conditions and drying soils have seen heat build up across inland parts of the country. Only 2 days into summer, severe heat waves affected Queensland and New South Wales, and there were bushfires in some southern states. So what's driving Australia's climate right now? Waters to our northwest remain warmer than normal, which may increase rainfall and cyclone activity in that area. In the tropical Pacific, ENSO has dipped close to La Niña at times during the year, but conditions now show it's unlikely to form in the next few months. So our ENSO outlook has moved back from La Niña watch to inactive. So what's the rainfall outlook for January to March 2017? Below average rainfall is likely over parts of eastern Australia, with above average rainfall expected in the northwest of western Australia. Outlook accuracy is moderate at this time of year. While we've yet to have our first tropical cyclone of 2016-17, we're still expecting an average to above average number of tropical cyclones this season. Turning to the streamflow forecast for December 2016 to February 2017. Near median streamflows are expected at most forecast locations as soil moisture returns to normal after the very wet winter and spring. Accuracy for our streamflow forecast is moderate to high at this time of year, with highest accuracy in the south. In terms of temperatures, days and nights are likely to be warmer than average for eastern Australia, but cooler than average in Tasmania and parts of WA. Accuracy for this outlook is moderate at this time of year. The seasonal bushfire outlook for southern Australia was updated at the end of November. More areas now have above normal fire potential for summer, particularly grasslands in Victoria and inland New South Wales. So in summary, rainfall is likely to be below average over parts of eastern Australia. Streamflows are returning to near median, temperatures are expected to be warmer than average in the east, and heatwave and bushfire potential is raised. For more details, go to our website at bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also get updates via Facebook and Twitter, or download our new BOM weather app. Our next video will be released on Wednesday, the 25th of January, 2017. Until then, have a happy and safe festive season. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Andrew Watkins.